His only son for you
and
for me. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
gave 100%. The least we can do is the least we can do. Amen. And not only did he die for us and made us worth something, gave his all in all, he keeps us every day. He answers every prayer. You don't think he does, but he does. Just doesn't happen in the time you want it to and the way you want it to. The Bible says we ought to pray without ceasing. Everybody has something they need to seek the Lord about.
Thank you, Lord.
Forgiveness, repentance, healing, sickness, wayward children, gone crazy spouses. We all have something we need to seek the Lord for. Prison bound, mentally bound, spiritually bound. Prayer can loose that. High blood pressure, sugar diabetes, kidney disease, fibromyalgia, lupus, COVID. God can loose that. But we have to believe by faith that if we ask, he will grant our petition. It's praying time. And it's time now for penny pan praying. It's time now for once a day, once a week praying with the deacon. It's prayer time. It's prayer time. Praying all the time. Your waking hours ought to be talking to God.
Come on.
People are dying by the second. I still can't get over the young man that went into the store to get food and got killed and left four children. Just went to get something to eat. He was a good man. He fed the homeless on a regular basis. On a large scale. But yet he's gone. We need to pray for his family. Pray for those children. Pray for their mother. We need to pray for ourselves. Our own households need to be loose and set free first. So they're passing around the prayer slips. So you can make your prayer requests known unto the Lord. And as you finish, we got a hand down front. As you finish your prayer requests, bring them to the altar and put them in the box. And then when you leave the altar, leave them. And expect God. We need a slip down front. Anybody paying attention to me?
Yeah.
Not necessarily. Nobody's moving. Got a hand down front for a piece of paper and a pencil. Amen. Yes, that's it, Becky. Y'all grab y'all some pillows and get on your knees. That's it. It's time out for plan. And while they're writing out their prayer requests, I want to ask you to but these kind, the Bible says, comes by fasting and praying. So I want to ask you to begin a fast with me tomorrow. And God just confirmed it all over the place today. I hadn't looked at the Sunday school lesson until this morning. But for 7 days, 7 hours a day, from 6 to 1 every day for 7 days, nothing but water. And we want to petition our God for this church, for the members of this church, for the ones that are falling by the wayside, for the needs of this church, all those things that Martine just talked about. We want to put that before the Lord, the resources that's needed in this church, the healing that's needed in this church, the deliverance that's needed in this church. We're still struggling financially because we haven't learned how to give to the Lord. Just your time. 2 hours and 40 minutes a day is all he required. But we can give more. So bring your prayers to the altar. Stay at the altar or find you a pillow and get on your knees somewhere in this church so that we can pray to our great God. God The Bible says that he would incline his ear to hear us.
Hallelujah.
There you go. Don't be too cute, too pretty. Position yourself all over this church, because there's somewhere in these chairs, all over these churches, this church, somebody is coming and they're going to be broken. And they're going to need to feel the presence of the Lord when they enter into this edifice. Amen. Still waiting on a few prayer requests. Bring them to the front. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that your ears are still open to hear us when we pray.
Yes, yes, yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's it. That's it. We're not too fasting. We just want to talk to the Lord. Hallelujah. Dear Heavenly Father, we just bless you today. We praise you. We worship you. We love you. We adore you. We magnify your most holy name. We thank you that you are our God, that you are our creator, that you are our savior, and you are our sustainer. We thank you, Lord God, for your son Jesus that died on that old rugged cross and shed his blood that we might have a right relationship with you. And now, God, we come before you confessing our sins, our deeds, and things that we've done and said that were not pleasing or acceptable to you. God, we bring them and we lay them at your feet and ask you to forgive us. And we get excited because you're so faithful that you will forgive us and you cleanse us and you restore us to the right fellowship so that our prayer and petition might be heard. When we cry out to you for the members of this church, when we cry out to you for the members of our family, in our own household, God, you will hear and you will answer our petition. God, there is so much sickness. There is so much disease. There is so much confusion. People are losing their minds. God, we need you to move in a mighty way. And every individual that's now bowed down before you or standing before you, God, they are bringing a petition to you that you already know about. And just because they ask you, God, and they're saying they have the faith to believe that you're going to answer their prayer, God, and for every prayer request that went in that box, we lift it up to you, we lift them up to you, we lift their families up to you, we lift their hurt up to you, we lift their financial situation up to you, we lift their sickness and diseases up to you. God, we lift their spiritual awakening up to you. Wake us up, God. Create us a clean heart. Renew a right spirit within us, God. Protect us, God. Don't allow the enemy to destroy us while you draw us back to where you need us to be so we can do what you created and called us to do. Help us to stand strong. And God, as we enter into this fast, give us strength. Help us to spend that 7 hours walking around those things, stomping out those things that are troubling our hearts and troubling our minds and troubling our schools, troubling our jobs, troubling our children, troubling our spouses, troubling our pastors, troubling our church, God. As we walk around those things, as we pray towards heaven and pray towards this church for 7 days, Lord God, for 7 hours, on that 7th day, God, we will shout the victory. You did it at Jericho, and I know you can do it right here in Fairfield. I know you can do it in Sacramento and Pleasant Hill and Stockton and Vallejo and American Canyon. All over this land, God, we're petitioning you today. Petition you for this ministry. We petition you for the pastor, the associate ministers, God. Every last one of them, we bring them to this altar. The deacons, Lord God, we bring them to this altar. The choir members, Lord God, we bring them to this altar. Synchronize our hearts and minds, God, that we can be on one accord so that you can do what it is that you called us to do, that we're so tight together that the enemy can't separate us with his mess. We love you so much, and we know how much you love us that you died for us. And God, as we surrender these petitions to you, we dare not leave out the bereaved. Mother Sam's family, Lord God, all those who have lost loved ones that are even years ago that are still struggling with the loss, heal the burdens, lift up their bow down here, dry the tears from their eyes. For Sister Jackie, the pastor of her husband, Sister Ruby, Lord God, the pastor of her brother, and God, a special prayer for Dr. Perry, who's lying on his sickbed, God, let your perfect will be done in the name of Jesus. Bless his house, bless his family, his wife and his children. Keep them strong as they go through this situation. And Lord, for our cities, our states, the government, the president, line them up with your will, God. Your plan for your people. That the decision that they make would be in accord with you are wanting to go forth for your people. All of your people. And God, we thank you in advance that while we're yet calling, you're already answering. Mending those hearts. Loosing the shackles of their hearts and minds, God. Loosing the shackles of those that are behind a prison wall. Healing those that are on their sickbed, in the hospitals, in the nursing home, at home, God. We thank you that while we're yet calling, you're already shaking up those that don't see the need to come down to the house of prayer and to praise you and worship you. Stir up their very foundation, God, and loose them from whatever holds them and bound them from having a relationship with you. We thank you in advance for the preached word that's getting ready to go forth, Lord God. Open up our ears and hearts and minds to receive it. Hide the man of God behind the cross. And don't let anything come forward except for what comes through the cross. And God, we thank you for the answering and all these petitions. In the mighty name of Jesus, and we will stand firm waiting on the testimonies. We thank you, God. And we say amen. Amen. And amen. Come on, give him a hand of praise. He said, tell him thank you for what he's already done. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. So worthy to praise. He's so worthy. He's so worthy. We're not worthy, but he is so worthy. He is so worthy. He is so worthy. We owe him so much. We couldn't pay him if we won the lottery. We couldn't pay him for what he did. He gave 100% of himself. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. And as our voices prepare to come and surrender sermonic selection, after that you will hear the voice of our illustrious senior pastor, Dr. Richard Douglas Clark. I know he has a word for you. He's been talking about it all week. I'm excited. I'm excited. So our voices are going to bring him in. And he is full grown, as Elder Child would say. He can tell, he can introduce himself as he speaks for himself. He knows the Lord. He has a relationship with the Lord. And God will speak to him and through him and to us. Hear ye him. Raise your hand and say with me, preach the word.
Preach the word.
Dr. Clark.
Dr. Clark.
Preach the word.
Preach the word.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, on today. We thank you for the blood.
Yes.
Yes.
For the blood.
Look out. Look out.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes. Yes. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank God for his blood. Praise God.
Thank you, Jesus.
The blood of Christ.
Thank you, Lord.
Hey, hallelujah, Lord.
Come on and keep your mind set on Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Hey,
hallelujah.
The blood of Christ.
Thank you, God.
The shed blood of Christ.
Thank you, Jesus. When I was on my way in this morning, I couldn't help but to just think about how good God has been to me all this week.
Yes.
He has seen me through some things. Hallelujah. And I thank God for his blood. Amen.
Amen.
One time, a thought of just the thought that wherever I am, sometimes I don't know what the devil is scheming on me, what his plans are against me. But I've made it. Amen. Okay. I've made it through. Hallelujah. Can you start that track over? Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. That's the wrong way. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The blood that Jesus shed.
Strength. Jesus. Jesus.